In this Chimp tutorial, we will cover the basic settings of the system and the show files. We cover all tabs of the setup menu and dive deeper into the input and output settings. The patch menu and the fixture library will be covered in depth in later tutorials. This tutorial is suitable for the full range of Chimp consoles. Show settings. To get to the setup menu, press the setup button in the top right corner of the screen, or hold down the open button and press the 7 in the numeric keypad. By default, the settings of the fader and button pages are set to autofix active faders. This means that when changing the fader or executor page, active faders and executors are moved to the new page until they get an off command and are released. We can change this to release faders on page change or leave faders active in background. If the option release faders on page change is on, all faders which are on page 1 will be released when switching to page 2. If the option leave faders active in background is on, the faders on the old page will stay active. When switching back to the first page, the console will remember all values of the faders. These options also apply to the button pages and can be set independently of each other. By default, the fader and button pages are not linked. If the link fader and executor pages options is checked, the button pages will be given the same release or leave values. If you use a Chimp banana wing and or a secondary monitor, you can choose whether or not to show the wing's fader labels on the secondary monitor. When a wing is connected to the console, this checkbox will be checked by default. On the Chimp on PC, this checkbox allows you to program the banana wing during the pre-programming. The Change Deslock Pin menu allows you to set a pin code to lock the console when you take a well-deserved break. By default, the console has no pin code. If lock desk is accidentally pressed, the console will ask to create a pin code. If the console is locked, you need to enter the code to gain access or restart the whole console. The User Interface Settings menu allows you to set the brightness of the desk lights and turn the key lighting on and off. Pressing the Timings button in the left part of the screen takes you to the Show Timing Setup menu. In this screen, you can adjust the default values of all fade, delay, snap, move in black, speed, and fade master values. In the left part of the screen, under the snap value, the snap percentage can be adjusted from 0% to 100%. The keyboard icon opens the keyboard and a value can be entered. Under the snap value section and on the top right at the move in black default timings, the user can adjust all parameter, move in black fade and delay times. If the user chooses a default in-fade time of 1 second, all newly programmed cue lists and cues will have a fade time of 1 second. So, the user can choose to assign a default fade time of 1 second to intensity and a default fade time of 2 seconds to position. The reset all cue timings to default button resets all settings to factory defaults. Under the heading Speed Master Settings, you can choose between seconds or BPM by selecting a cell under the heading type and pressing Set. You can also double-click on the cell you want to edit. The Speed Masters are typically used for chases. With type set to seconds, you can use the Speed Master fader to choose how many seconds there are between each step of the chase. You can also set a minimum and a maximum value between which the fader will move. With type on BPM, you can set the exact BPM value of the music via the Speed Master. Again, a maximum and a minimum can be set. Under the heading Fade Master Settings, you can set type, minimum, and maximum values just like with the Speed Masters. If the type box is set to relative, a master fader indicates how much the pre-programmed time may be used. For example, if a cue list has a cue with a 2-second fade time and the fade master is set to 100%, the cue will fade in 2 seconds. If the fade master is set to 50%, the cue will fade in 1 second. If the fade master is set to 0%, the cue will activate in 0 seconds. If the type window says absolute, then the fade master will always determine in how many seconds cue list can fade, no matter what is programmed in the cue. If the cue has 1 second of fade time and the fade master is set to 10 seconds, the cue will ignore the 1 second and use the 10 seconds of the fade master. System settings. The time, language, and keyboard settings can be adjusted under the System Settings heading. An external connected keyboard can be tested via the text box under the heading Select Keyboard Layout. Network settings. The IP address, subnet mask, gateway, and DNS server can be set via the Network Settings heading. The Test Internet Connection button allows you to test the connection to the internet. This is useful if you want to update your console via the internet. The top of the network settings menu shows the current state of the network. If the DHCP box is checked, the console will wait for an IP address from an existing router in the network. If you want to enter the values yourself, you need to check the box next to manual, after which you need to enter the correct data yourself. After changing the values, click the Apply Changes button. Now the console will adopt the new values. Wireless DMX setup. If you work with wireless DMX fixtures, you can link and unlink fixtures in the Wireless DMX setup window. The Chimp sends out Universe 1 via Wireless DMX. Maintenance. In the Maintenance menu, you can see the current software and fixture library version. Both the software version and the factory library can be updated in two ways. The software or library can be updated via a USB stick or via internet connection. If you choose to update over the internet, connect your console to the network that has internet access. You can test your connection in the Network Settings tab. If the connection works, press the Online Update button. The console will now request the list of all software updates from Highlight Server. Select the desired version from the list and press Download. The console will now start to update. When the console is finished, press Reboot Console. After restarting the console, the selected software version is installed. Installing from the USB stick is largely the same method as using the internet. The difference lies in the first steps of the update procedure. Go to the Chimp product page on the Highlight website. Download the desired software version. Unpack the zip file on a USB stick. Caution! Do not change the folder structure. The names of the folders are crucial for the console to find the software version. If the USB stick already contains Chimp shows, the information can be merged. Plug the USB stick into the USB port on the console. Go to USB Update. Select the desired software version and press Select. Then press Prepare Update and wait for the console to finish. Then press Perform Update. Wait for the console to finish and press Reboot. After rebooting the console, the software version is installed. The Release Notes button allows you to review the changes and bug fixes made in the current software version. On a Chimp console, the Calibrate Internal and the Calibrate External buttons can be used to calibrate both the internal and external touchscreens. If, for any reason, the calibration of the screens is not accurate and therefore it's not possible to press the buttons, you can always use the hotkey combination Infinity plus Open plus S1 for the main screen or Infinity plus Open plus S2 for the external screen to calibrate the screens. The front panel test button can be used to test whether all hardware buttons, faders, and encoders work correctly. Input and output. DMX output. Under DMX output, you can switch ArtNet and SACN on and off. You can also see how many universes are enabled in your current hardware. In the table, you can change the outputs by selecting the appropriate checkboxes. DMX input. In the DMX input menu, incoming DMX values can be read out and merged with an already existing universe. The values are always merged via HTTP. Under the heading DMX hold, you can choose if the console should hold the last values or release all values in case of DMX signal loss. MIDI input. Here, you can switch the MIDI input on and off. You can also make the MIDI input visible. The manual describes the MIDI notes and which functions of the console can be triggered with them. Sound input. An audio signal can be received via the XLR connector at the back of the console. The console has 6 sound triggers which can be set and switched on individually. By pressing Edit, you can set the frequency range and the threshold by means of the encoders. You can also assign a name to each trigger. Timecode input. In the timecode input menu, you can enable timecode and change the frame rate of the internal generator. You can also get external timecodes like MTC and LTC. The start and stop time of the internal generator can be changed by pressing the pen symbol next to the corresponding value. If the loop button is highlighted in blue, the internal generator will reset itself to the start time when the stop time is reached. The timecode input can be enabled and disabled by pressing the corresponding button in the top center of the screen. The reset timecode button can also be used to reset the clock to the start time. OSC connection. The OSC menu allows you to choose to receive an OSC signal. A standard layout for the Touch OSC app can be downloaded from Highlight's website. After downloading the app and the layout, you can follow the simple steps in the OSC connection tab to establish the connection. Shutdown. The shutdown button allows you to shut down or reboot the console. Thanks for watching.